Today we're going to be looking at some rare V-Nickels that are worth money. So Liberty had V-Nickels. If you guys have any of these coins, you can definitely look for these different types of errors that can make your coins valuable. So welcome back to Couch Collectibles. Hope you guys are having an awesome day. As always, if you guys are new, feel free to check out all the other coin collecting videos here on the channel. We upload every single day. So as always, let's just hop into this one. All right, so we're going to be focusing on the 1883 V-Nickel. Now some of these errors can take place on other dated V-Nickels as well, such as this coin here. It just has a, you know, small curved clip there at the bottom of the coin by the date. This is also the 1883 without the cents on the reverse. So what exactly does that mean? Well, here is a reverse of an 1883 where it says cents here at the bottom. So we'll zoom in. We see cents underneath the big V there at the bottom of the coin. Here's an example of what it looks like without the cents. So you got two different examples in the year 1883, E Pluribus Unum, there on the bottom of the coin. Now back to this coin here. This coin ended up selling for around $35 at auction. You know, it's graded at an XF45, so not a high mint state grade. That's, you know, why it sold for such a low value. You know, had it been a high mint state grade, this coin was sold for a lot more money. Now here's an 1883 V-Nickel that has a die break on the rim of the coin. So you'll see that there on the reverse of the coin here, that rim break. This coin ended up selling for a little over $60 at auction. Not too bad, graded at a MS61 by ICG. This one also does not have the cents on the reverse of the coin. Also, I should tell you guys, the 1883 without the cents, the one that says E Pluribus Unum, that's the better one. You know, they made around 5.4 million of those. The ones that say cents on the bottom, they made over 16 million of those. So really they're not low mintage, either one of them, you know, 5 million, 16 million. Just so you know, in 1883, there are two different examples there. Now this is a mint error coin, 1883 V-Nickel that was struck onto a defective planchet. We can really see that here on the reverse underneath the V there. Graded by PCGS at a mint state 63, this coin ended up selling at auction for over $90, nearly a $100 coin there. But here is a much more valuable coin, the 1883 high-graded example of this coin that does not have the cents on the reverse, has the E Pluribus Unum. This coin graded by PCGS at a crazy mint state 67 plus with that CAC sticker. Man, that is just crazy. This coin ended up selling for over $5,600. $5,600. For 5 cents. Now the last example was a mint state 67 plus. This is graded at a mint state 67 with the CAC sticker, but it does have the cents on the reverse of the coin at the bottom. So that makes a huge difference because they're two totally different coins, right? This coin ended up selling for over $25,000 at auction. Whew, 25 grand. Now here's a nice mint error. This is probably what most of our V-Nickels look like, this type of condition, graded at a VG8. This is the one with E Pluribus Unum on the reverse, and it has a major lamination there on the obverse of the coin. It is graded by Annex, and this coin ended up selling for around $75. Not too bad, nice lamination error there. Now here is a minor lamination taking place here on the reverse of a very good conditioned Liberty Head V-Nickel here, graded by PCGS at a mint state 64, and this coin sold for around $80 at auction. Now here's an 1883 V-Nickel that was split after the strike. So here on the reverse, you'll see that mint error taking place. You will not see a reverse design as a result of that mint error. Graded by NGC at an AU50, this coin sold for around $300, but that's not it. It sold with this coin as well. So we'll have a reverse on this coin. And then this one split after the strike as well, and it's missing the obverse. So two coins sold together for $300 at auction. We got the awesome mystery boxes. This is what the next person's gonna get in their mystery box. We got silver dollar, we got silver dimes, silver quarters, silver nickels, old nickels from the 40s and 50s. We got a silver certificate in this one, proof set. We got some more dimes, proof dimes in there, Indian head cents, buffalo nickels. They're bigger and better than they were when we first started these. Get one right now, couchcollectibles.com. Here's the 1883 with no cents on the reverse. It has the E Pluribus Unum graded at a VF30, only sold for around $20. So you see in this condition, not very valuable. Same thing with this one. This coin sold for around $45. It does have the cents on the reverse, graded at a VF35. So about the same condition there. And you know, low grades like this, they're not valuable coins. They either have to have a mint error or have an extremely high grade. Now here is an 1883 that was struck off center. This coin ended up selling at auction for over $200, graded by PCGS at a VG10. Now here's an extremely valuable coin here. This is the 1883 proof Liberty Head V Nickel that sold at auction for over $16,000 because, well, it's the proof and it's graded at a proof 67 deep cameo. This is the one with the E Pluribus Unum. Now here is an 1883 Liberty Head V Nickel graded by PCGS. Now this one has a repunched date. So you want to look for that with your coin microscopes on the 1883 date. Here's an example of one. There are several different examples for the year 1883. So you'll see that repunched on the 1, on the 8s, and on the 3. So look for that RPD, repunched dates. Here's another example of that as well. You can really see it there on the 1. So this coin ended up selling for around $65 at auction. You know, had it been a high mint state grade, again, it could have sold for a lot more money. Now here is an 1883 Liberty Head V Nickel where the obverse has been struck through. So you'll see that there as we zoom in on the coin, that strike through taking place. This coin is the proof coin and it's graded at a proof 64 by NGC. This coin sold for over $220 at auction. Alright guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Feel free to check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you guys in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles and this is where I disappear.